Love cares beyond all situations. A lover never seeks without being sought by his beloved. A lover never seeks without being sought by his beloved. When the lightning bolt of love pierced his heart. When the lightning bolt of love pierced his heart, be assured that there is love in the heart. Be assured that there is love in the heart. When the love of God grows in your heart, beyond any doubt, God loves you. Beyond any doubt, God loves you. O heart, if you recognize any difference between joy and sorrow, you will be torn apart. O heart, if you recognize any difference between joy and sorrow, you will be torn apart. Although what you desire tastes sweet, doesn't the beloved desire you? Doesn't the beloved desire you to be desireless? Oh, the life lover lies in death. You will not win the beloved's heart unless you lose your own. You will not win the beloved's heart unless you lose your own. Masnavi Volume 1. The other composition is from Masnavi, Volume 3. Jalaluddin Rumi, as we know him, is one of the most beautiful masters. The compositions in Masnavi and Shams Tabriz are unique. They contain the essence of life. One of these days, I will take the compositions of Jalaluddin Rumi to speak on those during these sessions. Love implies caring beyond all situations. Love implies caring beyond all situations and circumstances. Love is not concerned with biology as we think. When love is biological, it is not love, instead it is sex. Although to some extent it is a part of the growth or journey through love, but is only in the initial stages. As the flower of love begins to blossom, all the draws and all other things vanish. Love blossoms and flowers beyond the realm of the mind and all that is known. It belongs to the realm of the unknown. Someone had recently left hospital after an attack of virus. The attack was severe and the person had to stay for a while. She was feeling paranoid because her partner did not visit her. She felt as if he did not love her anymore. It is natural to feel negative after illness. Unless one was aware. Remember, illness is always a great catharsis. It comes to you as a catharsis. If you are aware, then illness helps in the process of inner clearing. However, her partner repelled that there was no hate in him for her. He still loved her. However, his initial response to her paranoia was one of anger. It is quite natural. There is a little misunderstanding that you have to understand, and which is a good thing to understand. Such misunderstanding comes because of your upbringing. When you love someone and when you are happy with the person, of course, health is the part of that happiness. You share the energy with someone because the person is healthy and overflowing. Then suddenly the illness grips one of the partners. Health is no more. You are left alone. Now the reason to be with the person is no more there. You were with the person because you were feeling happy and healthy. And the other person was healthy and happy as well. So everything was good and flowing rhythmically. Now the person suddenly falls sick. He or she is no more overflowing as before. And the whole point of being with the person is lost. You feel angry because your desires cannot be fulfilled now. What you called love, in fact, was not love. Instead, it was something else that you garbed as love. Unless you understand this, unless you understand that this is part of love, that sometimes the other will be ill, and that is natural. Sometimes you can be ill. Again, it is natural. This lacks feeling for one another. Such attitude is animalistic. Even animals have instincts. You have to be aware and responsible and see that when the other was healthy and happy, you enjoyed her health and happiness. Now the person is ill. In that you have to serve and care so that the person becomes healthy and loving and flowing once again. In the West, this is happening too much because the very thinking is not only wrong, instead it is misunderstood. People think that relationships are when they are happy, good. When something goes wrong, even a physical illness or something else happens, then why bother? Find another woman or man? This seems very inhuman, but this is how things are around us. So the first thing is to understand this and then learn to go beyond all these situations. If this attitude remains, if this understanding remains, love cannot grow. Then whatsoever you call love is nothing but sex. Because love means that you care for the person in health and in illness too. This is what the marriage vows are. You care for the person under all circumstances. I have heard one day Mrs. Nasruddin, Mullah Nasruddin's wife, was complaining to Nasruddin that now that I have gone old, you do not seem to care for me. And in front of the priest, you have taken the vow to be by my side under all circumstances. Mullah said, yes, I have taken the vow to be with you in riches and poverty, the health and illness. But there was no promise, there was no commitment to be with you in old age. So what is wrong about it? That was Mullah Nasruddin, not you. When the person loves and sometimes the person is not loving, then too you care. You care for the person and you accept all seasons of love and relationship. Sometimes the autumn comes, followed by winter. Winter is followed by spring. All these seasons comes in love as well, because love is a flower that has to blossom and has to go through all the seasons in life. If you have not lived your life like that, and a kind of remorse comes to you now, that had I known these things earlier, still there is no problem. You can go through those stages meditatively and clear your path. You accept everything that is in the person. Health is there, illness is there, old age is going to be there, youth is there, anger is there, hatred is there, everything is possible. Only then your love can one day transcend beyond all situations. And love has to transcend beyond all situations. Here you have to be careful, because when two persons live together, there arises togetherness and care. And this is often considered as love. You are sympathetic towards the other person. You have to be careful, because when two persons start living together, a kind of togetherness arises, and with that comes care. And this is not love as it is often considered. When you choose a person, you commit yourself to the person's totality. I am not saying that you should celebrate her illness. I am not saying that you should want to remain ill. Instead, you have to understand illness too is part of life. Try in every way to bring her back to health. But do not be angry with her, because now she is not flowing and you cannot. If you want to be angry with the illness. It is foolish to create any trouble for her or him in any way. Instead, help her to come out of this illness soon. In such case, the person herself will feel guilty that she is unable to comfort and these are the fill in the gaps that you have to fill according to your own. Illness is frustrating for you. Illness is frustrating you for the one on whom it has fallen, and for you too. You need extra money and care as well as to restore the health. The process of rehabilitation takes time and effort, but never directed towards the other. Of course, the person is ill, but she is not ill on her own accord. She has not chosen to be ill. One day you too can be ill, and this is the part of the game of being together, that we care about each other. In fact, love is known only when the other partner is in tremendous need of you. When everything is going well, it is nothing much. When things are going wrong and you still stick to the person, still stand by the side of the person, and then only you show that you are, that you belong. that the person belongs to you, that indeed is really togetherness. Togetherness is a secret and sacred commitment. Togetherness is a sacred commitment. It is involvement for better, for worse, for life and for death too. It is involvement for better, for worse, for life and for death too. If you really love a person, even death cannot destroy that love. What to talk of separation? It cannot destroy your love. Death may come, separation may happen, your beloved may die, you may be separated, but your love and your commitment will continue. When love reaches to that depth and height, it has the fragrance of the divine. Otherwise, it is very low and animal-like. What happens around us? The husband or wife dies, and no sooner that you find another person. This cannot be called love. I am not saying that you should not get another person, but for what reasons? You have to introspect. Is it for bodily needs that have not been transcended, or for other needs? So nothing is wrong. These are the situations one has to grow through. Put your anger against her illness, because you are feeling angry, and in that situation she feels that you do not love her, or that you hate her, or something. Such attitudes create misunderstandings. Maybe neither of you were aware of this. Make it clear to her that you do not want to remain ill, and that your anger is for the sickness and not for her. In fact, you are angry because you love her. Put your anger in the right direction and help the person to come out of this situation. Indeed, love is beyond all conditions, all situations that life brings. All situations that life brings moment to moment. Lover's ailment is not like any other. Love is the astrolabe of God's mysteries. Whatever love is from earth or heaven, it leads to God. The lover's ailment is not like any other. Love is the astrolabe of God's mysteries. Whether love is from earth or heaven, it leads to God. Rumi describes love as the astrolabe of God's mysteries. What is astrolabe? And why is this metaphor? Astrolabe is an early instrument used to observe the position and determine the altitude of sun or other astronomical objects. And Rumi uses the metaphor of astrolabe to explain the nature of love. Indeed, when love is the mystery, an unseen but realized truth, then certainly it is like the astrolabe of God's mysteries. It is the glory and awareness of love that soul can recognize its answering soul and feel a subtle presence echo across dividing time and space on life's roads. And when you are touched by the warning fingers of swift love, Only then the absorbed and rapt traveler can discover familiar splendors in an unknown face. It is love that thrills your being again to an immortal joy that wears a mortal body for delight. It is the insight of love that has experienced a power within inner sanctum that knows beyond human knowings. It is the heart that is enchanted with love, really recognizes that we are greater than our thoughts, and sometimes earth unveils a new vision here. Love is a glory from eternity's spheres, and to live, to love, are signs of infinite things. Love is the winner. Love is the vision of inner oneness. Love harmonizes all that is discordant within. Love transforms. Love is alchemical in nature. It does not matter from where your journey begins in life. Whatever is the nature of love, whatever be the beginning, one thing is certain. Love is ultimate. Love's ultimate destination is God. God implies your totality. And when you love existence like one being, then all your sins can really vanish. Love enchants your being. Love kindles the spark of totality of love in you for the entire existence, sentient and insentient. In that state, whatever and wherever you will look, you will find oneness. Such is the vision of love. Love indeed is the vision to totality. Rumi continues, whether love is from earth or heaven, it leads to God. Indeed, love does take you to the inner oneness first, and in that state it becomes cosmic. Whatever be the form of love, certainly it leads to God. God is the ultimate fruition of love. God is the ultimate fruition of love. Subhanallah.